You're watching a reality check exclusive. A group of MPs from the European Union were in Srinagar today, given rare access to the under lockdown state, seen as an attempt by the governor to send a message to the global community that all is well in the valley. But the visit has been shrouded in controversy, crucially over who's organized it. India says this is a private visit, but the MPs have been given the full red carpet, meetings with the Prime Minister no less, a briefing by India's National Security Advisor, and of course, a fact-finding visit, as it were, to Kashmir, something almost never granted to a delegation of foreign politicians. But now, we may have uncovered at least one layer of the mystery of who is behind this visit, thanks to an email exchange that has been accessed by NDTV between one of the MPs who was invited and the organizer of the event. And that email is in the possession of NDTV. And the email has gone out to Member of European Parliament Chris Davies by somebody called Madhi Sharma. Now, she says she's organizing a prestigious VIP meeting with the Prime Minister of India, His Excellency Narendra Modi. And she says in that respect, he would like to meet influential decision makers from the European Union, and therefore she's inquiring if they'll be interested in visiting Delhi and then also scheduling a visit to Kashmir. This was sent on the 7th of October 2019, so it gives you an idea of when the government was planning this. But it begs the question as to who is Madhi Sharma and what are her credentials to deliver on such a big promise of meeting India's Prime Minister, because deliver she did. Here she is, you can see her with a yellow scarf, with the Prime Minister and other delegation members visiting India. Now, Madhi Sharma seems to have her fingers in many different pies, and it's not immediately clear what exactly it all amounts to. On her own Twitter bio, she calls herself, amongst other things, an international business broker. She's also associated, going through her bio, with a women's NGO called WESTT, possibly based in Europe. Also heads something called the Madhi Group, is a member of the Brussels-based European Economic and Social Committee, and also part of an India-British trade group. On the European Union's company's disclosure site, though, her name appears as Madhu Sharma. So she's Madhi Sharma in her emails, but she's Madhu Sharma on her disclosures to the European Union. Okay, let me go across to my colleague Shruti Menon, who's been looking closely at the multiple interests of Madhi or Madhu Sharma. So Shruti, over to you. And what exactly are all these different entities she's associated with?
Right, Vasu, so to begin with, let's start talking about the West Group, the West NGO, which is a European Union-based NGO, a women's group. And if you do a basic Google search of that NGO, what it throws at you is this bio about the West Group, West NGO. It says it's a women's economic social think tank, is leading women's think tank focusing on economic, environmental, and social development of women. And it also goes on to say at the political level, it likes to incorporate stronger human rights. And then in the very next sentence, it goes on to say that West seeks to be free thinking, apolitical, innovative. So if you go through the entire page, it doesn't really clarify what exactly West does, what exactly is their mandate. It's very garbled in their own description. And if you go to the Meet the Team page, Madhi Sharma, as you mentioned, is the CEO and founder of the West NGO. It says that she's also an entrepreneur running the Madhi Group. Now, what is the Madhi Group and who is Madhi Sharma? Madhi Sharma has her own website called madhisharma.org, and it lists out what are the businesses that come under the Madhi Group. Now, the Madhi Group it says, includes a business brokerage company, Muddy Magnesium, an import-export company, a tour company, and multiple businesses as listed out here on her own website. But if you just, and there is a link given down here of the Muddy Group, if you just click on that link to find out what exactly Muddy Group does, or if you want to, if you're curious about what Muddy Group does, this is where it takes you. The website does not work. It says that the IP address could not be found. So it really is unclear who Muddy Sharma is, what West NGO does, or what Muddy Group actually does.
Right, and more importantly, how all of this ties to the Prime Minister of India? How does all of this give her the credentials to be actually able to set up appointments with the Prime Minister of India? Now, even more intriguingly, her email to Chris Davey says that the entire cost of the visit of the MPs will be borne by something called the International Institute of Strategic Studies, which, going by its website, is a Delhi-based think tank, Shruti, is it not? What are we learning about this group,
this think tank? So this particular group, as you mentioned, a Delhi-based group, International Institute for Non-Aligned Studies, was set up in the 1980s. And if you go to their website, go to their leadership page, it says that it was founded by a person called Govind Narayan Srivastav. Now, we did a basic search of who Mr. Govind Narayan Srivastav is. He was the founder of the Srivastava Group, and their own website says that he passed away in 1999. So going back to IINS, International Institute of Non-Aligned Studies, after 1999, we really don't know who is part of the governing body of this particular institute, of this particular NGO, Delhi-based NGO. And if we go through the About Us page of this NGO, it says that the governing body of IINS comprises of parliamentarians, academicians, experts, diplomats, and media persons from all parts of the world. However, it is unclear as to who these parliamentarians and academicians are, who are part of the governing body of this NGO. So it's clearly it's not evident from their own website what exactly they do right now and who all are part of their governing body after their founder passed away in 1999.
And also, more importantly, how is this think tank funding the visit of almost 30 European MPs, paying for all their expenses, their flights, and their hotels, is again something that is not clear? And what is the link between Muddy Sharma and this NGO and Muddy Sharma and, of course, the Prime Minister of India? So we actually sent our colleague Arvind Gunasekar down to this office of the NGO to see what he could get.
We are standing right outside the office of the International Institute for Non-Aligned Studies, which, according to Muddy Sharma, actually funded the trip of the European MPs to Kashmir. When we called the office on their official number available on their website, the person who took the call said the point of contact, Mr. Sujoy Dhawan, has just stepped out and he is not presently available. But when we came to the office directly, they just told us that the office is closed today on account of Bhai Dooj holiday and the officials will be available only tomorrow.
All right, we have, of course, reached out to Muddy Sharma, and we will continue to reach out to the think tank as well as all those associated with this story to get details of exactly how they came to be associated with this trip and, more importantly, with the Prime Minister of India. And we'll update our report as and when we get those details. Now, remember, as I mentioned, all of this began because Chris Davies, the Liberal Democrat member of European Parliament, who says he was bumped off the trip because he wanted unfettered access to people in Kashmir, is the one who released the email exchange between him and Muddy Sharma. And I spoke to him earlier today to ask him exactly how the events unfolded. There have been more than one MEP, it's not just you, there have been more than one MEP who's come forward and expressed concern both about what's happening in Kashmir as well as about this visit. We have Theresa Griffin, MEP, who says, to be absolutely clear, the group of far-right MEPs, because the flavor, the character, the nature of this group has turned out to be almost largely far-right, currently visiting Kashmir, are not in any way an official delegation. They do not speak for the European Parliament. The shutdown in Kashmir must be ended and constitutional rule of law restored, she says.
Well, I agree with Theresa. She also comes from northwest of England. She's from the Labour Party, she shares my view. I had no idea who else was being invited to go to Kashmir. It's news to me that so many of the MEPs that did accept and were offered places were from the right of the political spectrum.
That's right. A predominant number of those MEPs are from parties like the Brexit Party. They're from Marine Le Pen's party. They're from the Italian far-right parties and so on and so forth. That seems to be largely that's the composition of this group.
Yeah, I want to make it clear that clearly within the European Parliament and the debates we've had on Kashmir there have highlighted this. Opinions are divided. I mean, there are supporters, the strong supporters of the government's actions, and there were those like myself who were expressing concern both about the short-term policies that are being applied and the long-term consequences of this action.
Right.
It just doesn't seem to me that the action, from what we hear, and a lot of this is third hand, what we hear about media restrictions, great military control, communications difficulties, and communications clampdowns. All of these, and of course a lot of imprisonments, all of these things suggest that the government is not going out of its way to build bridges with the Kashmiri people.
All right, joining us tonight on Reality Check, we have with us KC Singh, a former diplomat, joining us on the show. Also, Syed Sohail Bukhari, spokesperson of the PDP. Also, Geeta Bhatt, academician, political analyst, supporter of the RSS. And Vijeta Singh, deputy editor, The Hindu. Now, KC Singh, you're a seasoned diplomat. When you look at now all these details emerging about how this visit, already quite controversial, has been organized, you've got some kind of obscure think tank. You've got someone who calls herself an international business broker but says she can organize meetings with the Prime Minister. Have you in your career ever come across something like this?
Look, basically, let me start by saying that all countries use this. They use NGOs, they use fronts to basically cultivate people, bring them into the country, sell them their line indirectly rather than saying is from the government, because many of them may not be willing to accept an invitation from the government.
Right.
But the problem with the current arrangement is it's a magic show where all the strings are showing, where the puppets have fallen down. It's very, very badly done. And the other additional problem is the context. You pick up a whole gallery of rather unsavory characters. They represent a fringe of European opinion. And in fact, you will create a reaction amongst the mainstream in Europe, which you are trying to influence. And then in addition, there is a problem locally. Normally you market your country to other parliamentarians because you are together in this, because your country is together.
Yeah.
Here you're not giving access to your own parliamentarians and you're marketing it to these unsavory characters. So
right.
What you are trying to do is show some people from Europe and say they've given us a character certificate, so all of you keep quiet.
Yeah.
There's nothing more to be said about this. Now
right.
That is, I think, just so badly handled. Particularly, I think Prime Minister should have kept away from it. At best, they should have met the External Affairs Minister.
Hmm.
But the fact they haven't shows that maybe MEA has nothing much to do with this. This has functioned through other groups from outside going up to Prime Minister, and they have convinced him that this is the best way. I don't think he's been properly briefed.
Right. It's quite possible, actually, that as these details are emerging, that he's not. Because Vijeta Singh, I mean, I'm not sure what details you're getting, because again, if you can just put those images up on screen, you know, this is the thing that, as if KC Singh is saying, this is a technique used by all countries to try and organize these visits, but to give the government a one-arm distance. But who are the intermediaries you use? Like this person, Madhi Sharma, who we've, spoken about. She's there with pictures with the Prime Minister of this country. But yet, if one looks at her own credentials, it's unclear what makes her qualified to organize something like this. She says she's, amongst other things, an international business broker. Vijeta. Right. Okay, we'll just try and get Vijeta Singh's audio in just a second. We're having a little bit of a problem with that. But essentially, Geeta Bhatt, the same question to you. That is this really how these trips should be organized? By people who say that they're international business brokers, the funding is coming from a think tank that, We don't know how it can fund this whole affair. And Geeta Bhatt, this lady is saying that she can organize VIP exclusive access to the Prime Minister of India.
Well, Vasuji, you see, these MPs who are here on a private visit, so exactly on what basis they have, they have been funded and how they have come here,
yes.
I am not privy to any such information.
Well, however,
I want to, you have put in some facts, but my question here is, yes.
You put the information out, they've been invited by some lady called Madhi Sharma, who says that she is guaranteeing exclusive access to the Prime Minister of this country. Who has authorized her? Who has given her the authorization? And by the way, she has delivered on that promise. She has delivered on that promise.
No, Vasuji.
She has come with these MPs and she is posing next to the Prime Minister.
Vasuji, you are not letting me speak.
Yes.
You see, what she is boasting that what she can do is something which she is doing in her personal capacity. Is there anyone, in the government who has come out and kind of made her or given her some position that she can arrange or fix some meetings? But I want to put in And that
how
is
can
that
she,
today,
how can she
today,
do this?
There has been, Vasuji, you are not letting me. You are not letting me speak, Vasuji. Please
okay,
let
go
me
ahead,
speak
go
at
ahead.
Least for a minute.
Go ahead.
My question is as a channel and as a media house, people can look into and try to look into the facts, who has organized the trip for these 27 MPs who have come. But the fact remains that if it is Jammu and Kashmir which we are worried about, today there has been an attack in Pulwama in a school where a board examination was going on. And five children were trapped over here.
Extremely
unfortunate. Why is it that no one is talking about it? Why is it that the opposition leaders who are going out and making so much
extremely unfortunate, but what does that have to do?
To visit Kashmir.
What does that have to do with our story at hand?
No, but the question is that why is that is more pertinent and more important to be discussed? That why is it?
No, it's not either or. It's not either or. We are discussing, but this is deflection.
I do not see anyone condemning it.
What
see
are you
anyone
saying?
Debating
terrorist
it.
Attacks, terrorist attacks in this country.
In this country are not going
we
to
all report on
this.
It. We all condemn it. It is unexcusable. But what does that have to do with the current story?
No, but why? This is an important.
What does
issue.
That have to do with the
Not
current story?
In the last couple of days
what does that have
killed?
To do with the fact that you have people
in
coming?
There
into this country, meeting the Prime Minister,
see,
organized by somebody
see,
who we don't know
see,
what her credentials are. As someone who feels very strongly about this country, about national security, see, about national pride, the Prime Minister, how are you okay with this? Shouldn't you be questioning this? Aren't these important questions to raise?
You
how
see,
does somebody access the highest office
of
this
all,
land?
Vasuji, when they are on a private visit, they have come... Vasuji, they have come to visit India. They have not come to visit Jammu and Kashmir. They are visiting many states. Among them, they are visiting Jammu and Kashmir.
No.
And
no,
the government
no,
is
no, no, no,
in
no.
facilitating that.
No, not
so
at all.
The point
let me try
is
to go back
that
to.
They have come
let me try
a,
to go
with
back
a
to Vijeta
to visit
Singh.
Many states.
No,
they have
absolutely
come to visit
wrong.
Many states.
Wrong.
This is one of the one
wrong,
of the
ma'am. I cannot allow wrong facts
so
on this show. I cannot allow wrong facts on this show. They have
no,
only been invited
is, what
to meet the Prime
Vasuji,
Minister and visit Kashmir.
That
that's it.
Vijeta
Singh. Okay, we'll have to silence Mike as Geeta Bhatt is not allowing others to speak. Vijeta Singh, if we can try to hear from you, is there, because as KC Singh was saying, it's always important for the government to try and put some plausible deniability between themselves and such efforts. But now, as he was saying, with all these details coming out, the sort of mechanics of how this has been put together seems to be getting exposed.
So, at least two ministries, the Ministry of Home Affairs and the Ministry of External Affairs. Ministry of External Affairs told my colleague Suhasini Heather that they did not coordinate this visit and they have nothing to do with this. And even sources in MHA, they told us that you can ask the army. So, obviously, two ministries have been, the two ministries involved in, diplomacy and maintaining internal security, they have been kept out of this visit. And my problem is, my point is that they can be from far right, they can be from far left, they can be from anywhere. But when the Indian parliamentarians are not being allowed, they need permission of the Supreme Court to visit Kashmir. How are they being allowed to visit such a sensitive place? If there is a security problem, if there is anything, like what is the rationale behind it when you don't allow your own parliamentarians to visit Srinagar? They were made to return from the airport. That is my limited point. And obviously security concerns are there.
Right. Syed Bukhari, you know, today the delegation was there. As it is, there are these question marks about how they were brought there. Now, were any mainstream politicians in Jammu and Kashmir allowed to meet them?
Well, Vasu, I mean, that question at this point in time is absolutely meaningless to me as a Kashmiri, leave aside my association with the People's Democratic Party. In the context that we are talking, I mean, we are talking about this incident in the context of what happened in Jammu and Kashmir on August 5 and how I would say a midnight heist was perpetrated by the ruling party and the parliament of this country on the people of Jammu and Kashmir. In that context, everything that has been following is almost nothing. What are we even talking about right now? After going through what we did, whole population under siege, no communication, mainstream political parties, the leadership in detention, separatists, not to talk of them, activists, even kids. A complete clampdown, almost a million boots on the ground.
Yeah.
Are we going to talk about this? Well, you know, all I can say is that, you know, this I had heard somewhere, that the problem with propaganda is that if you do a bit too much of it, the danger is that at some point in time, you'll start believing in your own propaganda and you know what the result is going to be. Apart from the fact on this incident, apart from the fact that the kind of shame, I would say, that this event has brought, in, you know, contrary to what would have been probably the aims of those who were behind organizing it. This, of course, for us as Kashmiris, we wouldn't, you know, even think too much about it. Given the fact that we are talking about an administration and the government who did not allow 80-year-old ladies to sit on a peaceful march, they were taken to jail. Is there anything left that we are going to talk about on this particular issue?
Casey,
there's something called morality that we would talk in good old days that does not exist anymore. So this is all.
Casey Singh, Casey Singh, so as you were saying, that if the idea was to derive any positive publicity from this visit, the manner in which it has been done, the selection of the MPs, and also now, Casey Singh, as it's emerging, the mechanics of who's behind it, these individuals, these groups, some kind of obscure think tank, some lady with business credentials or what, we're not exactly sure what she does. All this is, I mean, is this going to then, how is the government going to handle the sort of the fallout from this?
Look at the pictures. I mean, at least the pictures we are seeing, that there was a voluntary hartal. The shops are shut. They are being shuttled from one place to another under police escort. Now, of course, they can visit the valley. They can come and see. There is no violence. There are no protests. By the same time, there is no vibrance in the valley. There is no freedom of people moving about, expressing themselves. So if the idea is to simply market this to a very select group in a controlled manner, obviously it's not been very successful, because Chris Davies has exposed the whole thing. Then the financing itself is so transparently, so opaque that you don't know who's funded it, why it's been funded, how it's been funded. And it must have cost about a crore of rupees, because business class tickets about 1.5 lakh, then spending on everything else, 27 people will cost about a crore. Now, can this agency in Delhi justify where that money has come from? I doubt it. As I said, this is done by different countries, but it's done so poorly and done so badly at the political level, at the mechanics level. And now on top of that, UN Geneva, which I have not seen before, normally Human Rights Council may tweet. UN Geneva, as the Director General's office, has tweeted saying that, you know, Indian government needs to do something about what is happening in Kashmir. So UN has, you know, really burst the balloon by doing that. You can say that, you know, they're talking out of their head, they're doing that, but it's still the Geneva office, headquarters of the UN, which is tweeting.
Right.
So you know, they've just invited, I'm sure, people.
Right, so Geeta, but in conclusion, you know, just to set the record straight, because you keep saying private visit, they've come to travel the whole country like they're here on holiday. They're not. I mean, the letter from this Madhi Sharma is clearly saying it's a VIP meeting with the Prime Minister of India. He wants to meet influential decision makers. It's being pitched as a meeting with the Prime Minister and then the Kashmir visit. The whole itinerary is given in the email and there's no reference to visits to anywhere else. And they actually did meet the Prime Minister and they did travel to Kashmir. So whatever this lady has promised, we still don't know on whose behalf she was acting, has all come true. And I think that's something which demands some serious answers from all those involved. We are completely out of time. We'll continue to pursue this breaking story on NDTV. Thanks so much for joining and for watching. For the moment, it's good night.